Well, I am really pleased to be asked, and it is a real honour to be asked to open an exhibition by your fellow photographers. The Photographic Society, I think, does reflect something of this particular university. It is populated by very talented people, and they get the work done. They will also scrounge your equipment at the drop of a hat. No. For most of us, I suspect, nowadays, we are deluged with visual images. They're on screen, on TV, on computer, on your phone, and a lot with commercial power behind them. And there is an instinct to stand back and defend yourself against image overload. The still images on the wall here, they invite you to stop, stand still, and to look. They represent a reality to us in a very particular way that helps us encounter the new and the familiar in a curiously intimate way. I can meet the brown bear and I can meet the lion and quite intimately, but without fear. If the lion or the brown bear were at that distance down the room, I would have serious digestive trouble and would be moving at a rate of knots out of here. And this is true of a lot of photographic work, war photography, for example, some press and documentary photography. It can let you see emotions, situations, other people's dreadful experiences in a way that you can look at them with an open mind and heart and take on board the content in a way that if you were actually in the situation with shrapnel or bullets flying, you wouldn't quite be able to do. So there's something really valuable in the represented reality in the still image. Capturing a moment in time is one of the distinctive marks of the photographic image. The moment may be the barest instant, like in the eagle photograph below, like that, and it's gone. And the moment has been caught. Or it may be minutes or long seconds, as you'll find in the London Wheel or the Aurora shots. In either case, a moment of time is plucked from the inexorable flux of change that surrounds us. Our faculty of time, our memory, is stirred in the viewer as it is almost absent in the image's construction. If you contrast a still image to a painting, Van Gogh, when he painted The Starry Night, probably had every starry night he'd ever seen encapsulated in the painting. It works the other way with a photographic image. There's a moment that catches your mind and invites your memory to elaborate and run and recall. And images are made within the shape of the viewfinder or the screen. The image is made by a confluence of line and shape, of texture, proportion, by the quality of light and shadow. These elements all blend by the photographer's use of the viewfinder's space. The line, the shape, the texture, the proportion of pieces are blended together by the photographer's use of the viewfinder space. And they blend into what Cartier-Bresson called the decisive moment. And Bresson's moment is not a shutter speed. It's not 1/30th of a second or 1/25th of a second. His particular moment gathered all the elements of the photographic image, the subject matter, the shape, the proportion, the line, how it fitted within the viewfinder. And all in his decisive moment, the images become eloquent of aspects of the real world. If the image is good, and some of these images are so good. If the image is good and well made, and if we, the viewers, look well with our eyes, I'll beat Jedward. We will find memory and mind are touched. And we may sense the delicacy and the sensitivity of the mind that saw and that made the image. Opening exhibitions is a bit odd in that you've looked at the images and seen them. Can we together, as a group, look and enjoy and declare this exhibition open? Talking about the images around, I was asked to pick one I liked particularly. Who was it did that? Thank you so much. I'm really appreciative. And I say my thanks to the Photographic Society for good experiences over the years. And